Hi, I'm Matt Bomb, and welcome back to the Bomb Movies presentation of Skyrim. Okay, here we are, still in the rain. The glorious rain and thunder and lightning. We're outside the Valheim Towers, and we're on our way to Ivarstead to find our way up this 7,000 steps to see the Greybeard. So, we're going to follow this road there. I'm sure we're going to pass lots of interesting things on the way, however, the rain is a bit troublesome. We need to kind of get out of it as soon as possible, so we're going to head to Ivarstead as quickly as possible. I mean, it's even tempting to cut down the mountain there, but I won't. We'll stay to the path. We won't go on the moors. Because you know what happens if you go on the moors. What's that? Is that a big white rat? Okay, we'll leave the big white rat alone. Right, what's going on here? Looks like there's a chef chasing someone. Sawmill. Okay. Is that a carriage? Can we get a carriage to Ivarstead? Do you think? Let's, Ooh, that was close. Someone just killed the chef. What's going on? Were they attacking the chef? Let's go and have a look. It's interesting. Oh, it was a spider. Spider that killed Jürgen. And who was that? Qajar. Qajar the chef. Okay, fair enough. Some free stuff there. Okay. I tell you what, there must be some erosion going on at the bottom of this place. The attrition that the water and the stones would cause, that wouldn't last very long, that home. But anyway. Hello.
A carriage is the safest way to travel.
Have you got an eye problem? Are you actually blind? I'm not sure whether I want to use your carriage. But you have got some protection from the rain,
where
so
do you
okay.
Want to go?
Can you take us to Iv? Oh no, okay, you won't take us anywhere. Never
That's
mind.
Fine.
Whistle?
Huh?
Is there any way you could help me with this little problem?
Gold solves most problems, doesn't it?
What, so I've got to pay you to teach? Okay,
yeah,
whatever.
The coin always greases the wheels. It's all in this note.
Okay. Note. Let's have a look at the notes you gave us then. Note to Whistler. Whistler, do you really think I could teach you how to whistle? What you need is more practice and the rest will come eventually. Oh, and do not worry, I'll put your gold to good use. Ha ha ha. Thanks. Thanks a lot. Are we going the right way? Oh, I keep doing the wrong one. There we go. Yeah, so I've got to keep this side of the river and go across the bridge. And then after the bridge, got to take the first right. And that takes us through a bandit camp. Okay, so we're going to have to fight some bandits. Whatever. Let's go.
And the Mexican from the face. Also gave me the Dragonborn of Legend.
I am the Dragonborn of Legend, apparently. Don't feel like it, but apparently we are. I am. Turgon is. Ta-da! Okay. Goat's being chased by a wolf. Dead wolf. Killed the mountain goat. Are you still shooting stuff? Oh, saber cat. Oh, it's a lynx. Okay, got the lynx. Oh, that lynx had leather. Is that another lynx? Yes, it is. Kill the lynx! Oh, where's my horse gone now? Oh, why are you in the river? What's that over there? Plague wolf. Okay, I need to kill the plague wolf because it's going to spread the plague. Let's go over the bridge. Got to stop kicking stuff. Horse, can I get to you without jumping in the water? Oh, no, I can't. Great. Oh, well. Oh, come on, guys. Can't you kill a little plague wolf? You've nearly got it. Go on, kill it. I'm sure they'll be fine. Catch up when you're done. Signpost to Ivarstead. Awesome. This way. I don't think we need to go off left or right anywhere. Just stay on this path. Can't turn around when I'm looking in first person. What's that? That's like an elk or something, isn't it? Okay. Is Sophia still chasing that plague wolf? Okay, I'm sure she'll catch up. We need to get to Ivarstead. Has it stopped raining? Has it actually stopped raining? Awesome! It stopped raining. Oh, thank goodness for that. I do get sick and tired of the rain. Okay. There's an awful lot of wild animals on this road. Right, we're gonna run through all the animals. Okay, I think we managed to run through all the animals. Let's just make sure followers are there. Not being chased. Okay, cool. Let's go.
I'm getting out of here.
Alright, you do that. So probably need to look at this signpost. If I stayed this way. Okay. What's that? There's too many wild animals. Okay, run! Gallop, gallop, gallop! Galloping away from the wild animals. They can't bite my horse because it's too fast for them. And there's loads of animals everywhere, absolutely everywhere. Some wolves there, some wolves there, some cats there, some lynxes there. Okay, that's enough of the runaway from animals song. Is Sophia fighting them again or is she coming? There we go, she's coming. Oh dear. Bunny! Bunny! Hello, Bunny! Hope my horse didn't just squish you. If it did, rabbit for dinner! Okay, Ivarstead. I think that says that way. And we're under attack. Why are we under attack? Troll. Let's go. Past the troll. A very small troll. Must be a dwarf troll or something. More wolves, my goodness! They're everywhere! Absolutely everywhere. Let's just do a little quick save. Right. Where's Sophia? Nice! I did actually give Zora the ebony axe. There you are! Nice of you to join us. And you've got to be the most cowardly horse I've ever seen in my life. Okay, maybe it will get braver as time goes by. Alright, What's that? It looks like a goat, but is it a goat? Some sort of mountain antelope thing? We actually going the right way. Seems to be going back on ourselves. Snapple Leg Cave. Don't really want to go into Snapple Leg Cave. Thanks. Don't like the name of Snapple Leg Cave. Map. I went completely the wrong way. How did I end up all the way over here? Okay, no point worrying about it now. Let's just keep going. Yes, hi, bye. I'll be off the horse every 2 seconds if I was to fight all of these wild animals. Okay, signpost. I think that says Ivarstead. The sun's shining on it a bit too brightly. Look at that. That's beautiful. At least we're getting to see the scenery. Bye, wolf. Right, before we keep going this direction, is it the right way? Yes, it is. Okay. Okay, that's just a dog. Wow, some friendly people. Some Imperials.
Move along.
Imperial business. Be on your way.
Yes, I'm getting on our way. Trying to get to Ivarstead before tomorrow comes. Okay. Ivarstead, this way. Okay, that wolf is interested in that fox, and so was a mage by the looks of it. Let's just go. I've got no idea. It sounds like someone's trying to shoot arrows at us, but we're just going to keep galloping. Oh, for goodness sake. Oh, silver wolf. Interesting. Okay, anything else?
Nothing.
Yes, apparently. Let's get all this loot.
I would admire your courage if I wasn't laughing at your stupidity.
Yeah, you've got to stop laughing at my stupidity. And is that my horse all the way over there? Oh dear. Okay, the signpost actually pointed this way now to Ivarstead. We must nearly be there, surely. That's Sophia's horse. Whoa, Ben! No, that's really not good. Really not good. Okay. Where'd it go? No! Not good, not good. Got him. Okay. For you! Is that Ivarstead? My blinking horse. You know, you're becoming more trouble than you're worth, you know? Okay. I'm very talented on eating and drinking and riding and killing dragons. Okay, I think this is Ivarstead.
I've been looking for you. Got something I'm supposed to deliver. Your hands only.
Okay.
Let's see here. I have a letter here for you. Looks like that's it. Got to go.
Where's the letter?
Riches beyond imagining. I found these words inscribed in ancient dwarven ruins in the Reach. I believe they mark the entrance to a forgotten city. My brother went in a few days ago and hasn't returned. I need someone I can count on to go in after him and bring him back alive. I've heard great things about you, which is why I'm asking for your help. I'll be waiting for you in the ruins. Please hurry. And remember, riches beyond imagining. Cassia.
Awesome! So, my tales of dragon slaying have reached Cassia, who apparently can make magical talking letters. Cool. Thank you for that, Coriel. The Forgotten City. Right, this is Ivarstead. You're a mercenary with a leg problem. And you need to be polite. Okay. Is there like two... And have you got eye problems? These... My goodness. Have they all got eye problems? Okay. Kind of concerning getting a carriage with blind drivers. Maybe they know the road by the bumps.
Nope.
Okay, Ivarstead. Finally! Haha! That's gorgeous, look at that. Okay, so this is the Vilmer Inn, or Vilmir Inn. I suppose that's the best place to start, isn't it, really? Okay.
If the accident never happened, I would be wed to some dashing marble. But how would you ever manage without me, huh?
At the moment, Zora, I'm not sure. Do you want to talk about
still
your sister
here?
Yet? Ah, you do. I never asked what happened to your sister.
Well, my sister doesn't come to Riverwood very often. But she sends a letter every now and then, just to let me know she's alive. She can take care of herself, but that does not mean I don't worry.
Okay, I'd like to meet your sister. She sounds fun.
Does she? My hero, you have not been listening to me. Or you would remember
joking.
That my sister isn't a friendly sort.
No, I was kind of being sarcastic.
She's kind of a witch.
A witch? When did that happen?
That is hard to say. I guess she's always been a bit different and good with magic. I don't want to say she was born a witch, but at the very least, she's not your typical mage.
Okay, still don't trust her. Maybe we ought to pay her a visit and make sure.
I see my leash does not trust me. How disappointing. Maybe I ought to reconsider who I call my favorite companion.
No, I'm just being cautious.
But it has been some time since her last letter. I'm starting to get worried. We should stop by the Sleeping Giant Inn. Maybe someone has heard something.
Okay. We'll ask about your sister at the Sleeping Giant next time we're near Riverwood. The Children Fair. Interesting. I hope we can sort your face out. Feel sorry for you. Teagan's getting sentimental. Teagan is changing. Now I'm going to read these notice boards. Are you flirting over there with the guard, Sophie? Or at least she's not flirting with me. Right, messages. Beware of Shroud Hearth Barrow. Friends, family, I warn you to stay away from the barrow behind the inn. For some days now, I've heard odd sounds and voices coming from the barrow. And the other night, I finally had the courage to investigate it. By the Nine, some kind of horror now haunts Shroud Hearth Barrow. I saw it with my own eyes, a moaning spectre, all aglow with witchlight. Until someone deals with the undead menace, I advise you all to steer clear of the place. You all recall that adventurer who wanted to explore the barrow a good while back, when no one ever heard or saw him since. Now we know why. Warn any outsiders or pilgrims travelling the 7,000 steps as well. Innkeeper Wilhelm. Okay, impossible is only one word. Sometimes I see at my town at Rorikstead an old woman that reminds me of to my mother. She always tells her life story, a story of sacrifice, hard work and disagreements, but she never surrendered. Of course, all effort has its reward. Now, she is an old woman who can live in peace with her life and the life of others. If you speak with her, she will tell you that it doesn't matter how different a quest is, nothing is impossible, because impossible is only one word. We all must learn from her entire life, and from those wise words. That woman is my mother, and I want to share these words with everyone. Anonymous. That's nice. Leaving for Riften. Friend in Ivarstead, I wanted to let you all know that me and the family are evacuating Pinegrove Lodge and leave for Riften in a few days. With the current situation in Skyrim, the Civil War raging, dragons on the loose and everything, we have deemed it too unsafe to live so far from the safety of city walls, and thus it is with heavy heart that we pack up our belongings and abandon our home. I wanted to let you know that we have been very happy neighbours these past many years, and we wish you all well and hope you are safe. Should any of you wish to take over the house in our absence, we leave the ownership to you. It is highly unlikely that we will come back again. Eivind and Ud need to seek apprenticeship soon. We will find in Riften, and my wife wishes to start a small stall at the market. If any of you happen to journey to Riften, seek us out and say hello. I just hope you manage to get there alive. Terry and family. Okay, sorry about that. Just had a bit of a tickle in the back of my throat. Okay, the meeting point. What a good night last night was. So I met with my childhood friends. I'm speaking of Volan Longarm, Glimmet Courier, and of course, Boti. Or Botti. We have always dismissed our differences for the sake of adventure, but recently we needed to move all around Skyrim. Somebody was following us. We still do not know why, so we went to Rorikstead, then moved to Markarth. There we were able to pause, but continued our journey again. To Riverwood, and finally arrived to Winterhold, where we found ourselves no longer being pursued. Throughout that time, my friends told me that they had been followed from their own locations at Ivarstead. Ivarstead Klimek's house and Ivarstead Felstar Farm. We do not know who is following us. Maybe a drugger from Reachcliff Cave, a bandit from Fort Newgrad, or even an escaped Dwemer automation from Falbarthas or something. It remains a mystery to us. My friends have been chased all over Skyrim before meeting me, and have travelled from Eastmarch to Halfinger to Solstheim and eventually the Pale. We do not know who or what would have such a great interest in us. We are just a ragtag group of adventurers. This time, however, we made the decision to meet here in the Rift. The next time we need to move. Okay, that's all there is to that one. Visit Rorikstead. I came from Rorikstead. There are many beautiful women there. I came from Markarth. Nothing but old crones and hags. Stay away from there. Courier. Okay, fair enough. Finally, we've read all the notices. So is there any other jobs on the notice board? There's a bandit leader bounty. Bounty by order of Layla Lawgiver. To all able-bodied men and women of the Rift, the bandits located in Trevor's Watch have been harassing, robbing and attacking citizens and visitors. A reward will be offered to anyone who kills their leader. Anuriel. Okay, cool. And I've got all the other ones. Fine, let's head into the inn.
Welcome to the Villamir Inn. If there's anything I can get you, just let me know.
Okay, let's go and talk to the innkeep. Okay, not so many people in here. It's probably because it's mid-afternoon.
Your performances.
Since we're here, my friend, I hope you don't mind if I order something. Not very good, and it's
only for the same few people. No, fill your boots.
I think you play beautifully. It would be a shame if you stopped.
All right, Wilhelm. I suppose it's the least I can do for you.
Another attractive young lady. Oh, get your mind off of it, Turgon. Okay, let's talk to Wilhelm.
If I were you, I'd keep away from the barrow on the east side of town. It's haunted.
Okay, we'll get to that in a second, but can you refill my water?
Of course.
Thank you, and I just want to have a look and see what you've got for sale.
Let's sate that appetite,
I'm after some different sorts of drink. You haven't really got much. Have they got some salt? Those salt's very useful. I'll buy the salt. And carry. We're overloaded with salt. Okay. Have I got anything to sell you? Any stuff I don't actually want to eat? Yeah, you can have a leg of goat and some fish. I don't think I need that much cheese. Or that many apples. Okay. Fine. Oh, I got some double distilled skooma. Oh my goodness. Probably worth more on the black market. Okay. Fine. So, tell me about the Barrow first before we talk about Highhoth Hrothgar.
There ain't much more to tell. They're haunted, and you should stay away.
Look, okay.
I've seen one of the spirits with my very own eyes. When it glared at me, I swear it burned right through my soul.
So, do the spirits haunt your town as well?
Fortunately, they seem to be sticking to the Barrow. I think they're guarding it. Certainly isn't helping my business any. Who'd want to rent a room anywhere near a haunted Barrow?
I could investigate it for you.
If you think there's anything you can do, be my guest.
Well, I can have a look. You might have heard about me. I am a famous dragon slayer. Teagan. Okay, what else can you tell me? Has anyone ever explored the Barrow?
About a year or two ago, some fella named Windelius came through. Said he was some kind of a treasure hunter. I warned him not to go in there, just like I warned you. The very next night, we heard screams from the Barrow, and that was it. We never saw him again.
I'm intrigued. You know, I think Teagan is becoming braver every day. Where can I learn more about magic?
Sir, I've got no interest in magic users. No
right,
use
don't
for
screw
their
your face
kind
up.
Of call. They're way up north in Winterhold, and that's fine with me. I don't even like our Jarl having a court wizard.
Okay, obviously dead against magic uses with that look on his face. Anything you can tell me about Highth Hrothgar?
The Greybeards are a solitary lot. I don't think they've ever ventured outside their monastery. We get the occasional pilgrim passing through here on their way to the summit, but almost all of them have returned disappointed.
Okay, well that's where I'm headed. So I hope I'm not disappointed. Have you heard any rumors?
People say there's someone in Riften that can
change your
face.
Yeah, heard that one.
Make you look completely different.
Okay.
Do you believe that?
No, but whistle?
Huh?
I failed.
How can I argue with that?
You can't. Right, fine. Thank
you,
Willem.
Keep your eyes open in the Barrow. That's how they get you.
Okay, I've got concern on his face there. Right, so...
Is it I think I saw it again.
You are incredibly cute.
It was over by the Barrows.
You
see those warriors from Hammerfell? They've got curved swords. Curved swords.
I
first of all...
You safe.
Whistle.
Huh?
I'm not going to break my word.
Whatever you have to say, I don't want to hear it. What do you play?
I play the lute. If you'd like to hear something, it only costs 5 gold.
Later on. Another time.
Very well.
See you later.
A pleasant journey, my lord.
That's right. I am your lord.
Have you spoken to Fastred yet?
No. I'll tell you, Wilhelm. If I could sweep her away from here tomorrow, I'd do it. But Klimek still has so much to learn.
Klimek is doing just fine. You should follow your...
Okay. Everyone talking at once as usual. Ah, it's night time. When did that happen? Right, do we really want to climb up the 7,000 steps at night time? I'm thinking no. Who are you? Oh, you're the courier. Your note was quite funny.
Sorry, nothing.
Yeah, but you were quite witty. Alright, ladies, let's have a sleep here and we'll go up the mountain tomorrow. I think maybe we will have a song from the lovely barmaid here. Maybe we'll wait till she's put the tray down, however.
I have to wonder, what does the Dragonborn do once he's summoned by the Greybeards? Can the Thune be taught, like any skill?
Don't know, but I'll let you know once I've seen the Greybeards, because apparently I am the Dragonborn.
I think you should continue with your performances.
What's the point? I'm not very good, and it's only the same few people every night.
Look.
I heard the gourmet is hiding out somewhere in Skyrim. You know, fella who wrote that cookbook?
No, I haven't heard about the gourmet yet, I don't think, but I know what you play.
If you'd like to hear something, it only costs 5 gold.
Merely 5 gold? I'd easily pay twice that to hear you play.
That's so sweet of you.
Okay, so what are you going to pay?
I'll play a special song, just for you, for no charge at all.
Go on then.
Have you spoken to Fastred yet?
No. I'll tell you, Wilhelm. If I could sweep
you're
going to
play a song? There we go.
It.
You're playing it with the tray.
So much to learn.
Were they Klimek stuck to the tray?
Fine.
That's cheating.
Perhaps one day, but not today.
And your womanly parts are sticking through the loot? That is a nice song. Anyway, right, let's get a room.
We don't get many visitors through here. Unless they're headed up to High Hrothgar, of course.
No, I want a room.
Sure thing. It's yours for a day.
Thank you. Right, sleep time.
I'll show you to your room. Right. Who's this that? Way.
These Timber damn bears wide are driving arm. Me crazy. This has to be the worst place in Skyrim to run a mill. How am I supposed to do anything with all those bears running around?
Okay, I guess it's the bears making you angry. In fact, you're so angry, your womanly bits are freaking out. I would stop shaking if I were you. It's no good. It's no good to be so stressed. So what's making you so angry?
My business is falling apart. My apprentice never listens to me. And now there's talk of dragons. If I hadn't sunk every bit of gold I had into my mill, I would have picked up and left Iverstead long ago.
So you have a bear problem?
Are you kidding? Those damn things will drive me right out of business. Tell you what, bring me 10 of their pelts from anywhere in Skyrim. I'll gladly pay you for thinning out the herd.
Okay. So, whistle?
Huh?
And you really got to chill out because you are shaking all over the place. It was all your fault for staring at me like that and for shaking your womanly bits.
Whatever you say.
Okay.
Now go you give those stupid bears what's coming to
them.
You
want to see a doctor. Who's that?
If there are 500 steps to each marker, then maybe... Ugh, this is pointless. Daraki cannot rely on shortcuts.
Mm-hmm. Okay, Daraki. Is there anything I can help you with?
Yes, perhaps you can. There is something foul afoot, friend. Daraki can smell the stench of betrayal in the air.
Okay. Yeah, what you smell is skooma and it's not in the air, but on your breath.
Then hold your nose and open your eyes. Where one sense
Alright, calm
ends,
down, it was a joke.
The other may see the truth.
But it was a joke. Okay, you can explain your dilemma in detail.
Daraki talks of the steps to High Hrothgar. Many travelers come to walk the pilgrimage of the 7,000 steps. Yet Daraki finds that number peculiar. Do you not find it odd that the number is so round? Was the path altered to match the myth? Are the steps not all the same size? I have found it difficult to believe, based on my calculations, that there can be any more than 6,972 steps.
Rimmick is doing just fine. You should follow your heart.
Yeah, that number seems awfully arbitrary.
Not today. Exactly. A much more believable number. Still, it is just a ceiling. Daraki believes the actual number may be 10 or 20 steps lower. You can choose to ignore the truth, but Daraki will not. The steps must be counted one by one.
Okay, why is the number of steps so important to you?
It is about trust. You see, Daraki did not come to Skyrim alone. His childhood friend, Adanya, was by his side. Adanya had heard Khajiit caravans were thriving here. She begged Daraki to come with her. Adanya had promised Daraki that she would never leave his side. She vowed that she would never leave him alone in this cold, terrible place. But that was a lie. We had come through the gate to the south from Cyrodiil. We followed the road north when we were ambushed by bandits. There were so many of them. Daraki did not know what to do. That is when Adanya did a terrible thing. She pushed Daraki into the trees, threw herself at the bandits, and Daraki,
I think you will be dragging my lifeless
body saw her die
again. If Malax even managed to carry me to the top,
all he did was run.
Okay, so you lost your loved one. She didn't betray you, she saved your life.
No, she lied to Daraki. She broke her promise, and now he knows better. He will not fall for the lie a second time.
But it's only a number of steps. What
sugar
are you doing?
Sugar and sands.
Okay, you've convinced me, I'll count them.
Really? This is most fortuitous. Daraki had almost given up all hope. But do not rush. Take your time and return when you have an answer.
Okay, so the conspiracy of the 7,000 steps.
Should I buy my hero
Fine.
Drink? Will you be turning in early tonight?
You can buy me a drink if you want. Actually, let's go to bed.
What does the Dragonborn do once he's summoned by the Greybeards? Can the Thune be taught like any skin?
I'm right here.
I think
here we go.
It again. That ghost. It was over by
Come
the
on,
barrows.
Bedtime.
That thing's evil, Linley. I told you to keep.
Okay, it's now morning, and we're still in the tavern in Ivarstead. So we're now gonna go up the 7,000 steps.
Maybe I'm the Dragonborn. And I just don't know
so,
it yet.
Thanks for your hospitality. We shall see you all later. Right, it's about 6 o'clock in the morning. Sun will be
These
rising. Are you
bears
still
are
reading those notices?
Crazy.
Drinking a ale.
Nope. Sorry. Nothing.
Okay. Let's go. I think it's probably this way. Oh, look at those little chicks.
On your way up the 7,000 steps again, Klimek?
I thought rescue.
Not today. I'm just not ready to make the climb to High Hrothgar. The path isn't safe.
Aren't the Greybeards expecting some supplies?
Honestly, I'm not certain. I've yet to be allowed into the monastery. Perhaps one day.
Okay, I'm going up the 7,000 steps.
I'm right
passing
there.
Through on your way to High Hrothgar? About to make a delivery up there myself.
Okay, so what types of deliveries do you make to High Hrothgar?
Mostly food supplies like dried fish and salted meats. You know, things that keep fresh for a long time. The Greybeards tend not to get out much, if you catch my meaning.
And in return?
Well, it's kind of an understanding between us. I mean, it just wouldn't feel right to charge them for a bit of preserved food. Trouble is, my legs aren't what they used to be, and climbing the 7,000 steps takes its toll.
Okay, I'm going there, so I could do it for you.
Really? Well, that would be kind of you.
Yeah, I am quite kind.
Here, take this bag of supplies. At the top of the steps, you'll see the offering chest. Just leave the bag inside, and you're done.
Okay, anything I should watch out for during the climb?
Well, there's the occasional wolf pack or stray, but that's all I've ever had to deal with. Shouldn't be a problem for the likes of you. Other than that, watch your footing. In these wintry conditions, the stairs can be treacherous.
Well, I've got to actually count the stairs as well. Whistle?
Huh?
Maybe I should just wipe that smile out of your face.
No need to get rough.
No, I won't be rough. Okay, I'll be back once I've delivered the goods.
Be careful up there.
Unless the Greybeards sacrifice me to the gods or something. Right. Let's just check out the views. Ah, lovely. Right, okay. Is that a massive bear over there?
Poor Clement. The other townsfolk should really help him feed the Greybeards. And the winning food that makes them so nice.
There's a massive bear over there. Shall we, yeah, let's kill it. Oh. Shot. And another one. Ooh. That was cool. Let's go and get its furs. I was really expecting that to run over and, well, the last one wasn't easy. Okay. Oh, I'm over-encumbered Zora. Backpack, please. Dwarven crossbow. Okay, I had an awful lot of stuff. Oh, I actually want to wear one of those. Okay. That will probably do. No, let's give you these as well. God, I've got a lot of stuff to sell. But I'm glad, because we've got a lot of crafting to do as well, because I want to make some new equipment. Well, try to. Okay, that's better. Thank you, Zora. Right, well, let's have a look and see what these people have. Were they bats that just flew out behind me? Sounded like it. Meat pie. Ooh, meat pie. I'll take your meat pie and I'll raise you nothing. Right. Why are hunters wearing this? I would have thought hunters would be wearing hunterish clothing.
But I was okay. Clumsy.
What? I didn't do anything. Did I actually take the stuff off the bear? I did, didn't I? Yeah. Okay, let's have a look in here. Pine Peak Cavern, wasn't it?
ready to move?
Oh, there's another bear. Another bear.
Bears, my leash. Maybe we should throw them outside. Although that never seems to work.
Oh. Nice. Shot in the head. Okay, lantern. Potion, hemi armor, heavy armor forging. Awesome. Are my skills high enough for me to use more perks yet? Let's have a look in a second. Looks like the bears took some sort of traveler in here and ate him.
Yes.
Yeah, they did. Cool. Barumdun ore, that's actually rare stuff. Nice. Okay. Get as much as we can. Any more? Okay, that's probably it. Yep, awesome. Did I look in the chest? Did I not actually look in the chest? I did look in the chest, just done it automatically. On autopilot. Okay, out of character. Now, you probably noticed when I'm mining, I'm getting quite a lot of ore. And that's because I don't want to spend ages in the game mining. That's the reason. So I've basically used the harvesting overhaul to, or was it the crafting overhaul, one or the other, to increase the amount of ore I get when I mine, and the same with the wood. You might think it's unbalanced, well, I just don't want to spend an age mining. That's all. Okay. Let's go up the 7,000 steps, or 6,972, I think Dairaki said. More bats. Let's do a quick save. What's this thing? Kynes fire. Okay, interesting. Etched tablet. Emblem 1. Before the birth of men, the dragons ruled all Mundus. Their word was the voice, and they spoke only for true needs, for the voice could blot out the sky and flood the land. Fine. What's that? Oh, a goat. That sounds like a bear. Where's that coming from? Brown bear. Whoa! Was it running away? Oh, I've leveled up. That's running off to the goat. Ha ha ha. Awesome. Okay, nicely done. And I just leveled up, I think, didn't I? Right, let's have a look. It sounded like I leveled up, maybe I didn't. Oh no, I did, of course. Yeah, you leveled up. Choose an attribute to advance. Right. I'm actually going to take up Magicka. Okay, now can we get any skills? Yes, we can. Speech mastery. It's a license for 20% more. Your intimidation attempts always succeed. Ah, oh, nice. Okay, so, and We've got a few other things here. Performer grants a perform power once a day. Play a song to entertain up to 5 people within 50 feet and collect a donation from each based on your speech skill and the amount of gold they're carrying. Okay. And the universe listens. Shouting restores points of health, magicka, and stamina equal to your shout cooldown in seconds. You gain speech experience when shouting based on your shout cooldown. That's cool. Taking that one. Right. I wonder if we've got any others. Don't think lockpicking is good enough. Light armor isn't either. Archery. No more an archery yet. One-handed. Two-handed, that's unlikely. Hang on. Nah, don't worry. Block. Nope. Heavy armor. Nope. Smithing, I haven't done any smithing for a while. Nope. I think that's it. Okay, fine. Let's go. Just taking the view. That's awesome. Pillar of Stormblast, what's that? You do not have the shout fully unlocked. Okay. Interesting. Okay, there was a very low-res rock down there and it just sent me off on thought. But I can't squeeze any more out of the VRAM in this machine because I'll get crushed to desktop. That is pretty awesome. Okay. Who are you?
Keep an eye out for wolves if you're headed up the path to High Hrothgar.
So did you hear the Greybeards called Dovahkiin?
I did. Strange days when the monks will do that. I wonder what it means.
They were calling for me, and it means, Dragonborn, I think? Maybe? Whistle?
Huh?
Oh, so I can get him better. I think I'm getting better at this.
It would seem so.
Cool. What are you doing anyway?
I like to spend time up here.
You're not wearing
much. Walk the steps. Meditate on the emblems. Doesn't hurt when I bag some game along the way.
Okay, see you later.
Until next time.
Emblem 2. Men were born and spread over the face of Mundus. The dragons presided over the crawling masses. Men were weak then and had no voice. Okay. Oh, I haven't been counting the steps. I'm not going all the way down now. We'll just have to... Oh. He doesn't want to be lied to, does he? We lost the Greybeards. Okay, I'm expecting there to be more wildlife up here, but there's not. Oh. And then you hear the wolves. Okay, where are you? Ice Wolf. Okay, oh, you're running off again. Sophie, are you finally using your spells? Good girl. Okay. Ice Wolf pelt. I think I heard more wolves. Yep. Oh, sorry. Nice.
Should be cautious in case there are items.
Oh, let go. I don't want to hang up. carry around loads of legs of goat. They're quite heavy. Ooh, reindeer. At least I think that's a reindeer. It does look like a reindeer. I don't want to kill it. It might be one of Father Frostfall's reindeer. What's that there? Emblem 3. The fledgling spirits of men were strong in old times, unafraid to war with dragons and their voices. But the dragons only shouted them down and broke their hearts. Fine. Moonforge discovered. So is this the Moonforge? And what do you make in the Moonforge? Okay. So what do you make here that you can't make elsewhere? Ah, some awesome weapons. An ancient Wraith greatsword. Anduril. That looks awesome. Elven longbow with a massive amount of damage. That's nice. Elven short blade. That's cool too. Glamdring. Oh, there's some awesome weapons here. A Morgul blade. Narsil. Okay, well, we'll be coming back here at some point to make some awesome looking weapons. Spider-Man. Sting. And the Witch King's sword and the Wraith Greatsword. Okay. Awesome. Need to remember this place. Come back and make some awesome weapons. Where are you two? You coming? Good, yeah, come on then. That's probably about, oh, I don't know, 100 steps or so. That'll be an elk. Look at that view. That's impressive stuff. There's more steps over there. So we're supposed to like count all of the steps? I don't know. Really doubt there's 7,000 though. Maybe 700. I've got to stop and look at the view every so often. It's one of wonder. Okay, another shrine and someone sitting by it. Carita.
Keep an eye out for wolves if you're headed up the path to Hyrothgar.
Emblem 4. Cain called on Parthenax, who pitied man. Together they taught men to use the voice. Then dragon war raged, dragon against tongue. Okay.
By the gods, Carita. It's true, isn't it? A dragon has attacked Whiterun. How could mere men bring down such a beast?
Well, we did. Who are
just
you?
Just a pilgrim. I'd prefer to leave it at that, if you don't mind.
No, I don't mind. See you later.
Alright then.
Okay, now that is a very, very awesome view. From the top of the world here. Okay, I wonder how much further we've got to go. I don't know, what's that, about 300 steps? Okay, this looks like a perfect ambush opportunity. What's that? Oh, it's a troll. A frost troll. Oh, they're tough. They hit hard. So is it running away? Ooh. Dead.
At least they like to think so.
We do grow stronger with each fight. We do. Tegan isn't so much of a wuss anymore. I don't think he'll be spending as much time down the tavern anymore. Which is a good thing. And well done for taking most of the hits there. And don't look too shocked about it. There are loads of iron arrows and I'm not going to bother picking them up. Emblem 5. Man prevailed, shouting Alduin out of the world. Proving for all that their voice... proving for all that their voice too was strong, although their sacrifices were many-fold. Okay, the grammar was a bit confusing there for a second. Awesome. Right, just a bit out of character, I want to talk about the Zed flicker, which you can see there when I move. In the distance, that flicker, which you might not have noticed until I pointed it out. Well, yeah. I can't reduce it anymore because I'm using the first person mod, which allows you to see your body, and I needed that for the archery overhaul that I'm using, but I can't actually reduce the Zed flicker anymore because of that mod. If I do any more changes, then I'll get massive clipping on my person, which is a lot worse than a bit of flicker in the far distant terrain. This Bleak Falls barrow, look. And you've probably noticed I'm using quite a few mods that improve the distant terrain and make it look pretty damn cool. You keep a lot of the detail there as well. Okay, what's that? 400 steps? Maybe 400 steps? Dunno. Okay. Okay. It's just an alcove. Okay, number 6. With roaring tongues, the Sky Children conquer. Founding the first empire with sword and voice, whilst the dragons withdrew from this world. Okay. Thinking maybe we should have brought the horses. This is number 7. Tongues at Red Mountain went away humbled. Jürgen Windcaller began his 7-year meditation. To understand how strong voices could fail. That's pretty cool. Okay, another shrine here. We must nearly be there, surely. Okay, Jürgen Windcaller chose silence and returned. The 17 disputants could not shout him down. Jürgen the Calm built his home at the throat of the world. Okay, I think this is High Hrothgar, and there's one more shrine to look at. Okay, last shrine I think before we head into High Hrothgar. Emblem 9. For years, all silence. The Greybeard spoke one name, Tiber Septim. Stripling then was summoned to Hrothgar. They blessed and named him Dovahkiin. Okay, so I'm like Tiber Septim. Oh, Hrothgar!
Well, we made it here alive, at least. This place is huge. I would hate to have been the ones who built it on the highest mountain in Skyrim of all places.
Yeah, that's one feat of construction. And we are up high, aren't we? Let's have a look. Look at that! It's Dragon's Reach. Can I see the lodge?
Climbing the 7,000 steps wasn't so hard. Harder than taking a nap, but easier than teaching a troll to dance.
Yeah, getting a bit cold out here, actually. Oh, there's another shrine thing. Emblem 10, the voice is worship. Follow the inner path, speak only in true need.
I'm right here.
Okay. Right, so I think we won't steal any of this stuff.
What they're saying about you? Perhaps you could show me what really happens when a dragonborn comes?
That's taking it one step too far, Sophie! Yes. Right, I think we need to put Klimek supplies in here. Yep. Okay, so we need to go back to Dahiraki and back to Klimek. And we need, first of all, to speak to the Greybeards. But you know what? We're going to have to do all of that a little bit later on. We are actually going the right way. Seems to be going back on ourselves. Snapple Leg Cave. Don't really want to go into Snapple Leg Cave. Thanks. Don't like the name of Snapple Leg Cave. Map. I went completely the wrong way. How did I end up all the way over here? Okay, no point worrying about it now. Let's just keep going. Yes, hi, bye. God, I'll be off the horse every 2 seconds. If I was to fight all of these wild animals. Okay, signpost. I think that says Ivarstead. The sun's shining on it a bit too brightly. Look at that. That's beautiful. At least we're getting to see the scenery. Bye, wolf! Right, before we keep going this direction, is it the right way? Yes, it is. Okay. Okay, that's just a dog. Wow, some friendly people! Some Imperials.
Move along.
Imperial business. Be on your way.
Yes, I'm getting on our way. Trying to get to Ivarstead before tomorrow comes. Okay. Ivarstead, this way. Okay, that wolf is interested in that fox, and so was a mage by the looks of it. Let's just go. I've got no idea. It sounds like someone's trying to shoot arrows at us, but we're just going to keep galloping. Oh, for goodness sake. Oh, Silver Wolf. Interesting. Okay, anything else?
Nothing.
Yes, apparently. Let's get all this loot.
if I wasn't laughing at your stupidity.
Yeah, you've got to stop laughing at my stupidity. Is that my horse all the way over there? Oh dear. Okay, the signpost actually pointed this way now to Ivarstead. We must nearly be there, surely. That's Sophia's horse. Whoa, Ben! No, that's really not good. Really not good. Okay. Where'd it go? No, not good, not good. Got him. Okay. For you. Is that Ivarstead? My blinking horse. You know, you're becoming more trouble than you're worth, you know? Okay. I'm very talented on eating and drinking and riding and killing dragons. Okay, I think this is Ivarstead.
I've been looking for you. Got something I'm supposed to deliver. Your hands only.
Okay.
Let's see here. I have a letter here for you. Looks like that's it. Got to go.
Where's the letter?
Riches beyond imagining. I found these words inscribed in ancient dwarven ruins in the Reach. I believe they mark the entrance to a forgotten city. My brother went in a few days ago and hasn't returned. I need someone I can count on to go in after him and bring him back alive. I've heard great things about you.
Past many years? And we wish you all well and hope you are safe. Should any of you wish to take over the house in our absence, we leave the ownership to you. It is highly unlikely that we will come back again. Eivind and Ud need to seek apprenticeship soon. We will find in Riften, and my wife wishes to start a small stall at the market. If any of you happen to journey to Riften, seek us out and say hello. I just hope you manage to get there alive. Terry and family. Okay, sorry about that. Just had a bit of a tickle in the back of my throat. Okay, the meeting point. What a good night last night was. So I met with my childhood friends. I'm speaking of Volan Longarm, Glimmet Courier, and of course, Boti. Or Boti. We have always dismissed our differences for the sake of adventure, but recently we needed to move all around Skyrim. Somebody was following us. We still do not know why, so we went to Rorikstead, then moved to Markarth. There we were able to pause, but continued our journey again. To Riverwood, and finally arrived to Winterhold, where we found ourselves no longer being pursued. Throughout that time, my friends told me that they had been followed from their own locations at Ivarstead. Ivarstead Klimek's house and Ivarstead Felstar Farm. We do not know who is following us. Maybe a drugger from Witchcliff Cave, a bandit from Fort Newgrad, or even an escaped Dwemer automation from Falbarthas or something. It remains a mystery to us. My friends have been chased all over Skyrim before meeting me, and have travelled from Eastmarch to Halfinger to Solstheim, and eventually the Pale. We do not know who or what would have such a great interest in us. We are just a ragtag group of adventurers. This time, however, we made the decision to meet here in the Rift. The next time we need to move. Okay, that's all there is to that one. Visit Rorikstead. I came from Rorikstead, there are many beautiful women there. I came from Markarth, nothing but old crones and hags, stay away from there. Korea. Okay, fair enough. Finally we've read all the notices, so is there any other jobs on the notice board? is a bandit leader bounty. Bounty by order of Layla Lawgiver. To all able-bodied men and women of the Rift, the bandits located in Trevor's Watch have been harassing, robbing, and attacking citizens and visitors. A reward will be offered to anyone who kills their leader. Anuriel. Okay, cool. And I've got all the other ones. Fine, let's head into the inn.
Welcome to the Billamere Inn. If there's anything I can get you, just let me know.
Okay, let's go and talk to the innkeep. Okay, not so many people in here. It's probably because it's mid-afternoon.
Since we're here, my thing, I hope you don't mind if I order something. Good, and it's
only for the same thing. No, fill your boots.
I think you play beautifully. It would be a shame if you stopped.
All right, Wilhelm. I suppose it's the least I can do for you.
Another attractive young lady. Oh, get your mind off of it, Turgon. Okay, let's talk to Wilhelm.
If I were you, I'd keep away from the barrow on the east side of town. It's haunted.
Okay, we'll get to that in a second, but can you refill my water?
Of course.
Thank you, and I just want to have a look and see what you've got for sale.
Let's sate that appetite,
I'm after some different sorts of drink. You haven't really got much. Have they got some salt? Those salt's very useful. I'll buy the salt. And carry. We're overloaded with salt. Okay. Have I got anything to sell you? Any stuff I don't actually want to eat? Yeah, you can have a leg of goat and some fish. I don't think I need that much cheese. Or that many apples. Okay. Fine. Oh, I got some double distilled skooma. Oh my goodness. Probably worth more in the black.
Which is why I'm asking for your help. I'll be waiting for you in the ruins. Please hurry. And remember, riches beyond imagining. Cassia.
Awesome! So, my tales of dragon slaying have reached Cassia, who apparently can make magical talking letters. Cool. Thank you for that, Coria. The Forgotten City. Right, this is Iv Ostead. You're a mercenary with a leg problem, and you need to be polite. Okay. Is there like two? And have you got eye problems? These, my goodness, have they all got eye problems? Okay, kind of concerning getting a carriage with blind drivers. Maybe they know the road by the bumps.
Nope.
Okay, Iv Ostead. Finally! Haha! That's gorgeous, look at that. Okay, so this is the Vilmer Inn, or Vilmer Inn. I suppose that's the best place to start, isn't it, really? Okay.
If the accident never happened, I would be wed to some dashing noble. But how would you ever manage without me, huh?
At the moment, Zora, I'm not sure. Do you want to talk about
still
your sister
here
yet? Ah, you do. I never asked what happened to your sister.
Well, my sister doesn't come to Riverwood very often. But she sends a letter every now and then, just to let me know she's alive. She can take care of herself, but that does not mean I don't worry.
Okay, I'd like to meet your sister. She sounds fun.
Does she? My hero, you have not been listening to me. Or you would remember that my sister isn't a friendly sort. That's
no, I was kind of being sarcastic.
She's kind of a witch.
A witch? When did that happen?
That is hard to say. I guess she's always been a bit different and good with magic. I don't want to say she was born a witch, but at the very least, she's not your typical mage.
Okay, still don't trust her. Maybe we ought to pay her a visit and make sure.
I see my liege does not trust me. How disappointing. Maybe I ought to reconsider who I call my fervid companion.
No, I'm just being cautious.
But it has been some time since her last letter. I'm starting to get worried. We should stop by the Sleeping Giant Inn. Maybe someone has heard something.
Okay. We'll ask about your sister at the Sleeping Giant next time we're near Riverwood. The Children Fair. Interesting. I hope we can sort your face out. Feel sorry for you. Tegan's getting sentimental. Tegan is changing. Now I'm going to read these notice boards. Are you flirting over there with the guard, Sophie? At least she's not flirting with me. Right, messages. Beware of Shroud Hearth Barrow. Friends, family, I warn you to stay away from the barrow behind the inn. For some days now, I've heard odd sounds and voices coming from the barrow. And the other night, I finally had the courage to investigate it. By the Nine, some kind of horror now haunts Shroud Hearth Barrow. I saw it with my own eyes, a moaning spectre, all aglow with witchlight. Until someone deals with the undead menace, I advise you all to steer clear of the place. You all recall that adventurer who wanted to explore the barrow a good while back, when no one ever heard or saw of him since. Now we know why. Warn any outsiders or pilgrims travelling the 7,000 steps as well. Innkeeper Wilhelm. Okay, impossible is only one word. Sometimes I see at my town, at Rorikstead, an old woman that reminds me of to my mother. She always tells her life story, a story of sacrifice, hard work and disagreements. But she never surrendered. Of course, all effort has its reward. Now, she is an old woman who can live in peace with her life and the life of others. If you speak with her, she will tell you that it doesn't matter how different a quest is, nothing is impossible, because impossible is only one word. We all must learn from her entire life, and from those wise words. That woman is my mother, and I want to share these words with everyone. Anonymous. That's nice. Leaving for Riften. Friend in Ivarstead, I wanted to let you all know that me and the family are evacuating Pinegrove Lodge and leave for Riften in a few days. With the current situation in Skyrim, the Civil War raging, dragons on the loose and everything, we have deemed it too unsafe to live so far from the safety of city walls, and thus it is with heavy heart that we pack up our belongings and abandon our home. I wanted to let you know that we have been very happy neighbours these... Hi, I'm Matt Bomb, and welcome back to the Bomb Ruby's presentation of Skyrim! Okay, here we are, still in the rain. The glorious rain and thunder and lightning. We're outside the Valheim Towers, and we're on our way to Ivarstead to find our way up this 7,000 steps to see the Greybeard. So, we're going to follow this road there. I'm sure we're going to pass lots of interesting things on the way, however... The rain is a bit troublesome. We need to kind of get out of it as soon as possible. So we're going to head to Ivarstead as quickly as possible. I mean, it's even tempting to cut down the mountain there, but I won't. I won't. We'll stay to the path. We won't go on the moors. Because you know what happens if you go on the moors. What's that? Is that a big white rat? Okay, we'll leave the big white rat alone. Right, what's going on here? Looks like there's a chef chasing someone. Sawmill. Okay. Is that a carriage? Can we get a carriage to Ivarstead? Do you think? Let's, Ooh, that was close. Someone just killed the chef. What's going on? Were they attacking the chef? Let's go and have a look. It's interesting. Oh, it was a spider. Spider that killed Jürgen. And who was that? Kajar. Kajar the chef. Okay, fair enough. Some free stuff there. Okay. I tell you what, there must be some erosion going on at the bottom of this place. The attrition that the water and the stones would cause, that wouldn't last very long, that home. But anyway, anyway. Hello. Peter,
my carriage is the safest way to travel.
Have you got an eye problem? Are you actually blind? I'm not sure whether I want to use your carriage. But you have got some protection from the rain,
where
so
do you
okay.
Want to go?
Can you take us to Eve? Oh no, okay, you won't take us anywhere. Never
That's
mind.
Fine.
Whistle?
Huh?
Is there any way you could help me with this little problem?
Gold solves most problems, doesn't it?
What, so I've got to pay you to teach you? Okay,
yeah,
whatever.
The coin always greases the wheels. It's all in this note.
Okay. Note. Let's have a look at the notes you gave us then. Note to Whistler. Whistler, do you really think I could teach you how to whistle? What you need is more practice and the rest will come eventually. Oh, and do not worry, I'll put your gold to good use. Ha ha ha. Thanks. Thanks a lot. Are we going the right way? Oh, I keep doing the wrong one. There we go. So I've got to keep this side of the river and go across the bridge, and then after the bridge, got to take the first right. And that takes us through a bandit camp. Okay, so we're going to have to fight some bandits. Whatever. Let's go.
And the Mexican from the coast could possibly be the Dragonborn of Legend.
I am the Dragonborn of Legend, apparently. Don't feel like it, but apparently we are. I am. Turgon is. Ta-da! Okay. Goats being chased by a wolf. Dead wolf. Killed the mountain goat. Are you still shooting stuff? Oh, saber cat. Oh, it's a lynx. Okay, got the lynx. Oh, that lynx had leather. Is that another lynx? Yes, it is. Kill the lynx! Oh, where's my horse gone now? Oh, why are you in the river? What's that over there? Plague wolf. Okay, I need to kill the plague wolf because it's going to spread the plague. Let's go over the bridge. Got to stop kicking stuff. Horse, can I get to you without jumping in the water? Oh, no, I can't. Great. Oh, well. Oh, come on, guys. Can't you kill a little plague wolf? You've nearly got it. Go on, kill it. I'm sure they'll be fine. Catch up when you're done. signpost to Ivarstead. Awesome. This way. I don't think we need to go off left or right anywhere. Just stay on this path. Can't turn around when I'm looking in first person. What's that? That's like an elk or something, isn't it? Okay. Is Sophia still chasing that plague wolf? Okay, I'm sure she'll catch up. We need to get to Ivarstead. Has it stopped raining? Has it actually stopped raining? Awesome! It stopped raining. Oh, thank goodness for that. I do get sick and tired of the rain. Okay. There's an awful lot of wild animals on this road. Right, we're gonna run through all the animals. Okay, I think we managed to run through all the animals. Let's just make sure followers are there. Not being chased. Okay, cool. Let's go.
I'm getting out of here.
Alright, you do that. Okay, probably need to look at this signpost. Ivarstead, this way. Okay. What's that? There's too many wild animals. Okay, run! Gallop, gallop, gallop! Galloping away from the wild animals. They can't bite my horse because it's too fast for them. And there's loads of animals everywhere, absolutely everywhere. Some wolves there, some wolves there, some cats there, some lynxes there. Okay, that's enough of the run away from animals song. Is Sophia fighting them again or is she coming? There we go, she's coming. Right. Oh dear. Bunny! Bunny, hello bunny! Hope my horse didn't just squish you. If it did, rabbit for dinner! Okay, Ivarstead. I think that says that way. And we're under attack. Why are we under attack? Troll, let's go. Past the troll. A very small troll, must be a dwarf troll or something. Okay. More wolves, my goodness! They're everywhere! Absolutely everywhere. Let's just do a little quick save. Right. Where's Sophia? Nice! I did actually give Zora the ebony axe. There you are! Nice of you to join us. And you've got to be the most cowardly horse I've ever seen in my life. Okay, maybe it will get braver as time goes by. Alright. What's that? It looks like a goat, but is it a goat? Some sort of mountain antelope thing?